Hi students, today we are starting our next topic, that is PET, positron emission tomography. It is a functional imaging technique that uses radioactive substances known as radio tracers to visualize and measure changes in metabolic process and in other physiological activities including blood flow, regional chemical composition and absorption. Positron emission therapy, that is PET scan, is an imaging test that allows doctor to check for disease in our body. The scan uses a special type of dye containing radioactive tracers. These tracers are either swallowed, inhaled or injected into a vein into your arm depending on what part of body is being examined. Certain organs and tissues then observe the tracer. When detected by a PET scanner, the tracer help your doctor to see how well your organs and tissues are working. The tracer will collect in areas of higher chemical activity, which is helpful because certain tissues of the body and certain diseases have a higher level of chemical activity. These areas of disease will show up as bright spots on the PET scan. The PET scan can measure blood flow, oxygen use, how your body uses sugar and much more. A PET scan is typically an outpatient procedure. This means you can go about a day after the test is finished. PET scans are most commonly used to detect cancer, heart problems, brain problems, including problems with central nervous system. Now cancer. Cancer cells have a higher metabolic rate than non-cancerous cells. Because of this high level of chemical activity, cancer cells show up as bright spots on the PET scan. For this reason, PET scans are useful both for detecting cancer and for seeing if cancer has spread, seeing if cancer treatment is working, checking for a cancer recurrence. However, these scans should be read carefully by doctor as it's possible for non-cancerous condition to look like cancer on a scan. It's also common for solid tumors to fail to appear on PET scan. Now we are starting with imaging instrument MRI. MRI used as strong magnetic field and radioactive waves to create detailed images of the organ and tissue within the body. MRI technique is used to assist in medical procedure and research. The article looks specifically at MRI scan, how they work and how doctor use them. MRI scanning is non-invasive and painless procedure. The scanner itself typically resembles a large tube within a table in the middle, allowing the patient slide in. The development of MRI can represent a huge milestone of the medical world. Few examples of MRI where scanner can be used: abnormalities of brain and spinal cord, tumors, cysts and other abnormalities, breast cancer, injuries of abnormalities of joints, heart problems, diseases of the liver, and suspected uterine abnormalities, means uterus abnormalities in women undergoing evolution of infertility. Now here, patients will sometimes receive an injection of intravenous contrast liquid to improve the visibility of the particular tissue that is relevant to the scan. The radiologist, a doctor who is specialized in the medical images, will then talk the individual through the MRI scanning. Once the patient has entered the scanning room, the doctor will help them onto the scanner table to lie down. The staff will ensure that they are as comfortable as possible by providing blanket or cushion. Once in the scanner, the MRI technique will communicate with the patient via the intercom to make sure that they are comfortable. They will not start the scan until the patient is ready. Functional magnetic resonance or MRI is used to measure the cognitive activity by monitoring blood flow to certain areas of the brain. The blood flow increases the area where neurons are active. This gives an insight into the activity of neurons in the brain. This technique has revolutionized brain mapping by allowing researchers to assess the brain and spinal cord without the need for invasive procedure or drug injection. Functional MRI helps researchers learn about the function of a normal, diseased or injured brain. Functional MRI is also used in clinical practices. Standard MRI scans are used for detecting abnormalities in tissue structure. However, an functional MRI scan can help detect abnormalities in activities. Now we are starting with ultrasound. Sound waves with frequencies higher than the upper and audible limit of human hearings are called ultrasound. The limit varies from person to person, is approximately 20,000 hertz. The physical properties of ultrasound are similar to the normal audible sound. This type of scientific concept is used in many fields such as navigation, medicine, imaging, cleaning, mixing, communication testing, etc. Even in nature, bats purposes use this particular technique for the location of prey and obstacle. In the following section, we shall learn about its application. Medical ultrasound is a diagnostic imaging technique based on it. It is used for the imaging the internal body structure such as muscles, joints and internal organs. Ultrasonic images are known as sonograms. In this process, pulses of ultrasound are sent to the tissue using a probe and the sound echoes off the tissue, where different tissues reflect sound varying in degrees, and these echoes are recorded and displayed on the image. Today, whatever I have taught you, I am sending you its PDF. Thank you.